द टॉपिक इज टाइम पीरियड ऑफ मास लोडेड स्प्रिंग. टाइम पीरियड मीन्स टाइम टेकन फॉर वन ऑसिलेशन और वन वाइब्रेशन, बट मास लोडेड स्प्रिंग मेक्स द वाइब्रेशंस. दिस इज द स्प्रिंग. M mass is loaded, pull and release makes the vibrations, means it moves mean position to extreme position, means it moves on either sides of mean position. Mass M is loaded on the spring, is pulled and released, executes on either sides of mean position. Why it is executes on either sides of mean position? Due to restoring force which is proportional to displacement and lies in the opposite direction. How we can express that? That is F proportional to here displacement is Y. F proportional to minus y, opposite direction, so minus. Remove the proportional, TV will get one constant. This constant K is called spring constant. We know that from Newton's second law. F is equal to how much? Ma. From Newton's second law, F is equal to ma. Write F instead of F. Ma is equal to minus ky. You take this Me here denominator. A is equal to minus k by m into y. Take that as equation 1. And number of times I am said to you, you must be remember the condition of a simple oscillator. We know that acceleration is proportional to displacement but acts in opposite direction. What is the equation for it is A is equal minus omega square y. Let us take equation 2. A is equal to minus omega square y. Equation 2. Compare equation 1 and equation 2. A y, but omega square is equal to how much? K by m. Omega is equal to root k by m. What is omega? 2 pi by t is equal to root k by m. Take reverse, t by 2 pi and m by k. It is k by m, now it is m by k. Take here, t is equal to 2 pi root m by k. This is the time period of the mass loaded spring. What is the mathematical equation for time period of mass loaded spring? T is equal to 2 pi root m by k. We know that n is equal to 1 by t, so n is equal to 1 by 2 pi root k by m. This is the frequency of mass loaded spring. Now simple oscillator, we have one differential equation for the simple oscillator, that is called second order differential equation. The simple oscillator has one differential equation. Especially this is important for MPC students and also for BIPC students also. We will discuss this topic in second year, that's why I am explaining now. Now differential equation of simple oscillator, now how we can get it? We know that the statement is there, restoring force proportional to displacement. You take x or y, whatever it may be displacement. F is equal to minus kx. According to Newton's second law, F is Ma. Ma is equal to minus kx. M, what is the A? Acceleration. How we can write acceleration? A is equal to dv by dx or d square x by dt square. How we can get this? Now A is equal to dv by dt. A is equal to d by dt into, what about v? Dx by dt. So what we can get? A is equal to d square x by dt square. This is the mechanism for this. A is equal to d square x by dt square. We can get in this way. A is equal to dv by dt. What is v? Dx by dt. Acceleration, rate of change of velocity. Velocity, rate of change of displacement. D square x by dt square. So we can write A is like this. Okay. Sorry, don't take here m. Minus kx. Take m here. D square x by dt square. Minus k by m into x. What is k by m? K by m is equal to omega square. So d square x by dt square is equal to minus omega square a. Take in this side becomes plus. D square x by dt square plus omega square x is equal to 0. This is the differential equation of simple oscillator. But how much the order power? How much? 2. That's why this is second order differential equation and also differential equation of a simple oscillator. Here x is variable. If take x is equal to a sin omega t, you substitute x is equal to a sin omega t, we get the answer is 0. If we substitute x is equal to a sin omega t, here also a sin omega t, answer is 0. That's why this is the solution of this equation. This is the solution of above equation. Okay, this is the second order differential equation of the which one? Simple oscillator.